Okay, in today's lab, we're going to be looking at a lab that's called heating up or warming up. And in this lab, we're actually going to create an exothermic reaction. And basically, an exothermic reaction is when we have chemical reactants that when combined together, they actually release energy. And so in the process of atoms breaking apart, those bonds snapping apart, rearranging themselves and forming new bonds, it releases energy in the form of heat. So we're looking at a mild exothermic reaction, one that doesn't make a large adjustment in temperature, but nevertheless it will change in temperature to some degree. And so that's a process of those bonds breaking and reforming. In today's reactions, we're going to use just a couple different products or reactants. We're going to use 225 milliliters, so we're just measuring volume. I'm not concerned about the mass of the substance. But we're going to use 225 milliliters of plaster of Paris, which plaster of Paris is used a lot in construction. We use it to patch holes in walls. You might use it to create an imprint of a footprint. If you found if you were hiking on a nature trail and saw a deer print or a raccoon print in the mud, and you wanted to try to create a cast of that, you would pour the plaster of Paris in that footprint. Wait for a couple hours for it to harden, and then you can pull it back out. And it shows basically like a fossil of that footprint. So it's a way you can preserve the footprint and take it home. So that's what this substance is. We're also going to use water, and that just creates a solution. Once it's mixed with the plaster of Paris, will cause a reaction to start up. And we're only going to use 112 milliliters of water today. Okay. So I'm going to pause the video. We're going to zoom up to the lab table where you can kind of see what we're doing and see how we're graphing our work. This takes about 15 to 20 minutes for us to get the results we're looking for. So we'll kind of pause intermittently, kind of show you how the graph is looking, and just kind of take some information from that. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this lab. At the conclusion of the lab today, I'll show some student pictures of some of the students as they were working on the lab when they finished up. Okay? Thank you. Okay, in the lab today, we're using a temperature versus time graph to determine what is going on in our exothermic reaction. And so if you notice at the bottom, I have time listed right here. Time is generally on the x-axis 99% of the time when we have time listed as one of the variables we're looking at, because time can't change. And so time continues whether we want it to or not. We can't really stop the time. And so if you notice, it goes from 0 to 20 minutes. And I needed to find even increments to go from 0 to 20. So I counted by 2. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20 minutes. Now, I know that in a normal room temperature, because we always do temperatures in Celsius in science, a normal room temperature in science is around 23, 24 degrees Celsius. And so I know that's probably going to be my starting temperature. So between 21 and 24 is where I expect to start my graph. So at 0 seconds, somewhere along this way, my temperature of my substance is going to be in that range. And then hopefully every 2 minutes, we're going to start seeing some things happen. So every 2 minutes, we're going to check our temperature and see if it's rising or staying the same. And then we'll connect our dots to see what's going on. So this is just a representation of what we hope to expect to see in the lab. We never falsify what we see. We're going to be as accurate as we can be. In science, sometimes we don't always end up with the results we want. But we're going to try our hardest to see if we follow the procedure, if we actually get a exothermic reaction in this, okay? Okay, we already have our 225 milliliters of plaster. And so I'm going to go ahead and put it inside of this container, or inside of our baggie. So we're going to dump it inside, just like that. And I want to get a temperature reading of that plaster of Paris. So I'm going to stick it in to the plaster of Paris, and I'm going to make sure it's nice and coated on the bulb and see what happens. Okay, so I'm going to pause the video. We'll come back in about a minute. We'll check that temperature. Okay, our time shows that we still have about 5 seconds left to hit the 1 minute mark. So I'm going to go ahead and start getting this ready to read. So I'm going to wipe this off so I get a good clear reading. I'm looking for the purple or the gray line, and my starting temperature is right at, and I don't know if you can see it or not, but it's right at 25 degrees Celsius. And we always use Celsius in science. We never use Fahrenheit. And so what happens here is the mercury is in the bulb, and mercury is the only metal at room temperature that actually has, you know, it's only liquid at room temperature, for one. But the interesting thing about mercury is it's very sensitive to temperature changes. And so the temperature can just rise just a little bit, and the mercury will start expanding. So the mercury will rise up in the tube. If it starts to get colder, then the mercury condenses, so it starts to shrink back down into the tube. So that's what gets us our reading. But right now we're going to put down on our graph our starting temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. So I'm going to come up here for 0 seconds, and I'm going to put me a mark right here at 25 degrees Celsius. Okay? And that's where we will start today. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is I need 112 milliliters of water. Well, this is a 100 milliliter graduated cylinder, so I've got to use it twice. So I'm going to go ahead and pour in to the 100 mark. So let it get up there a little bit. And remember, I want to read the bottom of the curved line. Remember, the curved line is called the meniscus, and that is 100 even. So I'm going to go ahead and pour it into our plaster. And then I'm going to want another 12 milliliters, and 12 is right down here. And this actually reads, I believe, by twos. No, it reads by ones. So we can go up to the 12 milliliter mark right here. Oops, way too much. Slow it down a little bit. Wow, that's amazing. I can't believe I got it right there. But anyway, that's 12 milliliters right there. So we have 112 milliliters inside the bag. So I'm going to try to get all the air out of it that I can. Okay, made a little bit of a mess, but that's okay. Now I want to shake it all down, and I want to start mixing it up. Just kind of kneading it, getting it all mixed up. Feeling like it's pretty mixed up right now. Now what I'm going to do is lay it flat. I take my thermometer. I'm going to put it right about here in this area. And I'm going to use some tape. I'm going to tape it in place where I can still read it. So I'm going to put a couple pieces of tape to hold it in place. And then I'm going to fold it over because I want this bulb to be completely covered up with the substance or the solution, okay? So I'm going to cover that up, tape that down real good. Okay, so now my thermometer is pretty much wrapped around, or it's all wrapped up in that. I can still see my temperature, so I'm going to reset my timer. And every 2 minutes, I want to check that. So I'm going to rearrange the camera right now so we can see the timer, and hopefully we can also see what's going on with the temperature, okay? Okay, we just had 1 minute go by. I'm watching this temperature right here. I can already see that it's climbed just a little bit past the 25 mark. So it's gradually starting to climb, but not enough to notice, you know, a great extent at this time. So we'll let it go ahead and go to the 2 minute mark, which we're just a few seconds away from that. And so we're kind of watching this mercury line, hopefully seeing that it's climbing, because the name of this lab, of course, is warming up. So we're hoping to see an exothermic reaction in the process of these chemicals mixing with this water that we added. So we're at a minute and 35 seconds now, so just a few more seconds to go. Okay, so looking at my thermometer, it looks like it went up about a half a degree. That's not a whole lot right now, but I'm going to go ahead and mark that at my 2 minute mark. So right here on my, this was my beginning. So that was at 25. And so I'm going to go 25 and a half. So at 2 minutes, I'm going to rise the temperature just a little bit. It's not a whole lot. I'll go ahead and pause the video. We'll kind of look at it every 2 minutes, okay? Okay, we're coming up on 4 minutes now. And unfortunately, I'm not seeing a change in temperature at this time. So I'm going to go ahead and, at the 4 minute mark, go ahead and leave it at 25 and a half degrees, okay? We'll continue to go every 2 minutes and see how it goes. Okay, we're coming up on 6 minutes. And no change at this point, so we're going to continue to write down our temperature as still the same at 25 and a half degrees. We'll pause again. We'll look again at 8 minutes and see what happens. Okay, here we are at 8 minutes, and unfortunately, we're not rising in temperature. We actually just lost the half a temperature we had, so we're actually back down to 25 degrees. And so as I'm kind of looking at some things and looking at our lab procedure, it looks like the reaction may not actually start occurring until after 15 minutes has passed. So we're going to extend the time to go to an additional 15 minutes after our initial. So we'll actually run this for 30 minutes and see what starts happening, okay? So at this point, we're at 25 degrees. We were at 25 and a half degrees a minute ago, which might have been a difference in temperature of our water. So we're going to continue to watch it up until the 15-minute mark. Then we'll see if anything changes after that point, okay? Okay, we're coming up on 10 minutes, and it looks like our reading is still at 25 even, so we're going to continue with that cycle. We'll go another few minutes or so, see what starts happening. Okay, so at 10 minutes, it's still at 25, and so we're just moving on. If you want to see our results so far, right now my chart looks like this. We were at 25, went up to 25 and a half for a few periods of time, then we dropped back down to 25. And so we're just kind of almost running a straight line across the page right now. Okay, we'll pause it. We'll come back at 12 minutes. Okay, here we are at 12 minutes, coming up on it. Still 25 degrees. So we'll come back in 14 minutes and check our results at that point too. Okay, we are nearing 14 minutes now of our plaster mixture. Looks like it's still at 25 degrees. It might be coming up just a hair, but it's not enough for me to be confident in that. So I'm going to go ahead and put down 25 degrees for 14 minutes. We'll continue to watch it for a duration of 30 minutes and see if anything else occurs, okay? So we'll pause it, come back at 16 minutes. Okay, coming up on 16 minutes now. No noticeable change. I'm still recording 25 degrees for that period of time. We'll look at it again at 18 minutes. Okay, coming up on 18 minutes now. Still no change. We'll continue to keep it at 25. Kind of hoping our results will go up, but we got to stay consistent with what we see and record what our observations are. So we'll continue to pause, come back at 20 minutes. Okay, at 20 minutes now, still no change, 25 degrees. We'll check it at 22. Okay, we're at 22 minutes now, and still no change, so 25 degrees is where we still are. We'll keep it running until we hit the 30-minute mark, and we'll see if anything's happened from that point. Okay, here we are at 24 minutes, still no change. Still putting it down for 25 degrees. Few more minutes to go. Okay, we're creeping up on 26 minutes now. Still not seeing any change. Unless something happens pretty dramatic in the next 4 minutes, it doesn't look like this lab is going to produce the heat that was attempted to be mentioned in our summary. But we'll continue to watch it for another 4 minutes and see what happens. And regardless of whether we get our heat exchange or not, we can still learn something from this lab. So I have a few closing statements. If in the event nothing happens, we can kind of look at what our results show and how we handle that, okay? Okay, we're at 28 minutes almost. Still no change in temperature, so 25 degrees. We have 2 minutes left. Okay, we're at 30 minutes now, so a total of 30 minutes have passed since we started this lab, and still no change. So a little disappointing, was expecting an exothermic reaction. It did not happen. However, there was some students in class that did have some results that actually changed about 4 degrees. Here's what we learned, that we still record our data as we see it. Mine would just basically be a straight line. It kind of went up at first, which was probably a change in water temperature. Then it came back down and just stayed the same all the way through. So we didn't see a change in reaction on this particular lab in regard to a thermal change. So we still have to record our results regardless of what we find, what we expect to find. Good science means we still record what we see. We don't make things up, and we just continue on with what we have and what we observe. And so following this video, just watch for a few pictures of the students in class working on the same lab. And I'm glad there were some others that had some success. However, in this instance of my lab and trying to recreate it, we didn't have the results we were looking for. There are other exothermic labs that we could do to kind of show the temperature changes going up and down. So this lab, probably not the best one to do in the future, but I hope the students enjoyed it, and look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you.
Down from a broken sky, traced out by the city lights. My world from a mile high, best seat in the house tonight. Touchdown in the cold black top, hold on for the sudden stop. Breathing the familiar shock of confusion and chaos. All those people going somewhere, why have I never cared? Give me your eyes for just 1 second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Yeah. 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 Step out on a busy street, see a girl and our eyes meet. Does her best to smile at me, to hide what's underneath.